Faster air exchanges in buildings don't always reduce coronavirus levels. Excellent ventilation is one way to reduce the transmission risk of COVID-19 indoors. However, a group of researchers suggested that vigorous and rapid air exchanges might not always be a good thing in controlling the levels of coronavirus particles in a multi-room building. Researchers at the U.S. Department of Energy's Pacific Northwest National Laboratory investigated potential aerosol transmission and infectivity of SARS-CoV-2 in central ventilation systems. The team closely defined the situation as secondhand smoke being distributed into different rooms. Smoke levels could be reduced in a person near the air exchange, yet it could still spread at lower levels into nearby rooms. So the risk got substantially lower, though it remains present when it comes to respiratory diseases. As part of the study, researchers modeled the spread of tiny particles that mimic the coronavirus via air handling systems. Events were modeled after a person had a 5-minute coughing episode in one room of a small 3-room office building. Three factors were primarily assessed: the level of filtration, the rate of outdoor air going into the building air supply, and the hourly air changes. Results showed that downstream rooms clearly received benefits from increased outdoor air and better filtration. Yet the effect of increased ventilation was not as good as expected. When they analyzed different amounts of outdoor air going into the building air supply, from 0 to 33% per hour, more clean outdoor air decreased the transmission risk between connected rooms. Just replacing one-third of the building's air per hour with clean outdoor air cut the infection risk in downstream rooms by 20%. Study lead author Leonard P. said, "More outside air is clearly a good thing for transmission risk, as long as the air is free of virus." Besides more clean outside air, better filtration played a crucial role as well. Filtration levels MERV 8, MERV 11, and MERV 13 were tested, where the higher number means better filter. MERV 13 shrunk the peak concentration of viral particles by 93%. Ventilation or air changes per hour could decrease the risk by 75% in a single room. However, it would raise the risk in connected rooms. This is because the moving air has to go somewhere, and if the source room is connected, the other room is getting the not-so-clean air. Researchers are already working on another series of experiments to know more. The findings were published in the journal Building and Environment.